thank you all for joining. Great to be here at the Pelham Parkway Houses on a beautiful Friday afternoon. And I want to talk about housing today. And let me just begin with a very clear statement. Housing is a basic human right. Aside from food and water, it is the most important thing that any of us needs to survive. It is a prerequisite for maintaining stable work, educating your children, and living a healthy life. And where you live and how well you live can have wide-reaching effects that ripple out into the rest of your life and undoubtedly impact your future, your children's future, your grandchildren's future. Yet every single day, even before the pandemic, far too many New Yorkers are forced to live without shelter, and countless others are on the verge of losing it. And those who are lucky enough to find affordable housing often have to settle for unacceptable conditions. In the buildings right behind me, countless residents suffer from terrible conditions. Conditions that other non-NYCHA residents live to dream of. Exposed to health hazards like mold and left to deal with unanswered repair request after unanswered repair request. Although this might be startling to some, it shouldn't be surprising. As of 2020, NYCHA had a roughly $40 billion capital needs gap, which leads to leaky roofs and broken plumbing, or worse, mold and other health hazards, because there simply isn't enough money to go around. At this critical moment in our city's history, we need a mayor who understands these issues on a deeper level. We need a mayor who actually knows what they're doing because they've done it their entire career. I'm the only candidate in this race with the experience at all levels of government, particularly when it comes to housing, that's needed to get the $40 billion NYCHA residents need and deserve and to fix public housing in our city. The first step is recognizing all of the resources that are available at the federal level, if you know how to use them. I commend President Biden for including $40 billion in his infrastructure bill, specifically for preserving public housing. And I can confidently say that I can get more of that money to New York City than any other mayoral candidate. President Biden, Vice President Harris, members of their cabinet and members of Congress, these are people I have deep personal relationships with, not just people I met backstage at a debate. Beyond these funds, which will already go a long way in revitalizing our crumbling housing infrastructure, I know every other federal resource for housing support available, and I know how to make all of those tools work for our city in ways that our current administration has failed. I was responsible for NYCHA receiving billions of dollars in federal funding during other recent times of struggle, as part of the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act during the Great Recession, and as part of the Hurricane Sandy recovery effort that I led on behalf of the Obama administration. And after 20,000 units at NYCHA went over a decade without receiving funding from the city or the state of New York, I came up with an innovative and effective solution to federalize these units, making it possible for them to receive tens of millions in federal capital and subsequent annual subsidies as well. My relationships and experience coming up with creative solutions as President Obama's Housing Secretary and Budget Director will make a real impact on NYCHA's $40 billion shortfall starting on day one. No on-the-job training required. And I know from my decades working in housing in our city, including my time as the city's housing commissioner, that there are plenty of potential local solutions as well that we're letting fall by the wayside. I've outlined plans to overhaul NYCHA's governance structure to improve performance, drive decision-making closer to residents, and improve resident engagement and communications. And my administration will make a historic commitment of $2 billion per year in city capital dollars to accelerate repairs across NYCHA's portfolio. No other candidate has made that commitment, and no other candidate has the knowledge or experience to bring these plans to life. By accelerating energy efficiency and resilience efforts across NYCHA's portfolio, we'll also be able to bring in billions of dollars, improve the quality and resilience of its housing stock, lower operating expenses, and reduce greenhouse gas emissions while providing residents with a healthier and more comfortable living experience. And by partnering with unions to train workers, we can create thousands of jobs for NYCHA residents as well, for painters, and for so many others across our city. And wherever gaps still exist after all of these policies go into effect, Section 8 can be used to ensure that all public housing has the funding it needs to make necessary repairs. We should create a preservation trust and use another innovative solution that I developed while serving as President Obama's housing secretary, the rental assistance demonstration. It was designed as a comprehensive and innovative strategy to offer a long-term solution to preserving and enhancing the country's vital affordable housing stock. This groundbreaking program strengthens communities by making it easier to add retail, like grocery store, community facilities, and other things that benefit quality of life in public housing. And it can give residents the choice to keep their Section 8 assistance while moving to new housing if they prefer a different neighborhood. Because of RAD, NYCHA's already been able to make much needed repairs to dozens of their properties. But Mayor de Blasio hasn't implemented it in the way it should be, to the detriment of New York's communities. He's mismanaged conversion to Section 8, creating deep mistrust and fear of displacement among residents. And he's stoked fears of privatization of our precious public housing. Let me make one thing perfectly clear. RAD is not a privatization program, and I should know, I created it. At its core, RAD merely changes the funding source for public housing to make it more stable and to increase funding in the future, which doesn't require privatization at all. In fact, other housing authorities across the country have used RAD while keeping all parts of public housing oversight public, from development to management to financing. Let me give you one example. The St. Paul Public Housing Agency in Minnesota successfully used RAD to secure $220 million in federal funding and preserved 3,800 units in the program to keep up with repairs. But what we have right now is a mayor who fundamentally misunderstands how housing works and who makes no effort to deliver better results for New Yorkers. He just passes the buck again and again. The next mayor won't have the luxury of figuring things out on the fly. In this historic moment of crisis, there is no margin for error. We know how dangerous this is because we see the consequences every day this mayor is in office. I look forward to taking bold action and bringing about meaningful change from the moment I'm sworn in. That's what the residents of Pelham Parkway houses deserve. That's what residents of the Bronx deserve. That's what every New Yorker deserves. Thank you.